In the video today, we're answering a viewer question because Mike A. asks us, what is the difference between bees, wasps, and hornets? There are many similarities and differences between our little wing-whipping friends. For starters, they can all sting you. That said, you may derive some solace in the fact that when certain of them sting humans, they die. Although it's not true that they do that when they sting other animals. The barbed stingers on honeybees particularly end up getting lodged in our soft flesh, ripping out their backsides when they try and get away after stinging you. When they sting most other animals, that simply doesn't happen. Further, all three live in hives or combs. These humble modes are always in cooler and sheltered areas, often within the shade of trees. Bees, wasps, and hornets all proliferate in warm weather, their hives growing in the spring and the early summer. By late summer, food becomes scarce, and that's when they, especially wasps and hornets, start finding their way to human food and your picnic. While the colors are all pretty similar, brown and black, yellow, and maybe some white on bees, wasps, and hornets, the markings, they do differ. This is where the insects we all tend to lump into the same category, flying, stinging, and scary, begin to show their differences. Let's start with the humble bee. Bees are fairy pollen collectors who rarely ever have any need to interact with humans. As the expression, as busy as a bee insinuates, worker bees, usually the only type of bee that most people see, spend their lives going to and from the hive, acquiring nectar and pollen on their bodies during their trips. They play an integral part in the pollination of various plants, and some of them they provide us with tasty honey. They feed the acquired nectar to their young, developing the new generation of bees. They also protect the queen bee, allowing her to lay eggs. There are over 25,000 known bee species, but the two most common types of bees are honeybees and bumblebees. Both produce wax, but, and I know this is going to come as a shock, only the honeybee produces honey. Another big difference between the two is that the bumblebee is nearly double the size of the honeybee. Bumblebees are fat, at least in bee terms, and they're hairy. Their size, relative to their wingspan, gives rise to the myth that science can't explain how they're able to fly. Honeybees are more sleek. They both are yellow with black stripes, although the bumblebee often has a red-orange or white tail. Additionally, honeybees live in large colonies, topping out at 25,000 bees, while bumblebees tend to build their nests underground, although their nests have also been found in walls, and they're often found in tunnels constructed by other animals. Their colonies are much smaller than bumblebees, only numbering into the hundreds. Wasps, unlike bees, are aggressive and predators. There are over 30,000 species of wasps, and they are distinguishable from bees by their pointed lower abdomens and narrow waist. They also have little to no hair on their bodies, as opposed to bees, and they don't play much of a role in the pollination of plants. Their legs are shiny, slender, and shaped like cylinders. All wasps hunt for food, and they build nests for shelter. What exactly they prey on and how they build their nests depends on the type of wasp. There are two general types of wasps, social and solitary. Social wasps build colonies and start from scratch every spring, never nesting in the same spot twice. They design their home out of chewed up wood fibers and their own saliva. The nests may hold up to 5,000 wasps and are typically found in protected spaces like attics, inside of walls, or under decks. Social wasps eat many different types of things. They are omnivorous, including fruits, plants, human food, and other insects. Solitary wasps do not form colonies and live underground in tubular mud nests. There's no caste system, as in the queen cares for its own young. The queen seeks out prey, flies, bee larvae, cicadas — there's actually a species of wasp known as cicada killers — and they paralyze them with their sting. They take the still-living insect back to the nest and feed it to their lover. It's during the late summer that wasps begin to get aggressive. This is due to the fact that the worker wasp's job is done for the year and they're literally waiting to die. After taking care of the queen and feeding the new generation of worker wasps, the old ones, they're now useless. They become disorientated and begin to venture away from the nest in search of food and something sweet. As absurd as this sounds, these wasps have nothing left to live for besides satisfying their sweet tooth, so they become aggressive, bold, and persistent. They'll land on a human hand that's holding an ice cream cone, they'll dive into a can of soda, they'll munch on a half-eaten apple. In fact, in September of 2013, the British Red Cross warned citizens that wasps were getting drunk on fermented fruit and were going out in search of more. Joe Mulligan of the Red Cross said to the British newspaper The Independent in 2013, "It's hilarious that now worker wasps have finished their life's work. All they are now doing is feasting on fermented fruit and getting drunk." All that being said, wasps are not just pests, but they benefit humanity in some way. They prey on other pest insects, and have actually been used by the agricultural industry as an effective means to control crop pests, resulting in much more environmentally friendly ways to do this over many pesticides. Hornets are actually a species of wasp. Hornets differ from other wasps in that their stings are more venomous. They also tend to attack for food as a colony, and their nests are aerial as opposed to many wasp species. The giant Asian hornet, native to parts of Russia, China, Vietnam, and the mountains of Japan, can grow to about 2 inches long with a wingspan of about 4 to 5 inches. It is the world's largest and most venomous wasp. It is colloquially known as the yak killer due to the venom's ability to dissolve the tissue of even the largest of mammals. Because the honeybee is, on an individual level, incapable of harming the giant Asian hornet, and just a handful of giant Asian hornets are capable of decimating an entire hive of honeybees, the Japanese honeybee has come up with an alternate strategy to stopping the mass destruction of their populace by the hornets. When a giant Asian hornet is detected, first the honeybee will emit a pheromone that the hornet can pick up, and it basically says, "I see you." The scouting hornet might then leave. If not, and the hornet continues towards the hive, the honeybees will ball the hornet, essentially surrounding it completely with as many bees as possible. They will then exert themselves as much as possible in order to raise their body temperatures. Inside the ball, the temperature will rise rapidly, while simultaneously the carbon dioxide levels will also increase. Once the temperature inside the ball passes 115 degrees Fahrenheit or 46 degrees Celsius, it exceeds what the hornet can tolerate, but is still well under what the honeybees can handle. The combination of heat and low oxygen level will eventually kill the giant Asian hornet. Several of the honeybees will likely die before the hornet does, and this means of defense, it isn't effective against a large number of giant Asian hornets. However, it does work well against eliminating the scouting giant Asian hornet. This can potentially stop a large-scale attack from ever taking place. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do give us a thumbs up below, and do not forget to subscribe. Brand new videos just like this every day of the week. And if you're looking for another channel where I do also daily videos in a top 10 format, do check out my other channel, Top 10s. You'll find a link to that below. And as always, thank you for watching.